The first movement of Symphony No. 10 contains a rather brooding passage. The imperative to change notes results from what you do to develop the sonority. Just as flower blossoms seem self-unfolding, so must your tone feel self-producing. The sarcastic solo in the Allegretto has its roots in Shostakovich's signature motive, D, E flat, C, B natural. I add a crescendo going into the B double flat before 112, and several bars later, I exaggerate the printed crescendo diminuendo. The lamentation in the fourth movement recalls the recitative of the Ninth Symphony. Like the Ninth, this passage is built on the anguished falling interval, first a major third, then a fourth, then a minor third, and finally the fifth, B flat, E flat. The tempo marking is given in eighth notes. I read into this an invitation to take lots of time with the upbeats and passing eighths. If you have difficulty controlling the quiet B flat two measures before 150, try adding the low B array with your left thumb. Finally, we have the bumptious tune in the last movement. Use a dry staccato, be imaginative with your contours, and make a difference between the major and minor fragments. The orchestral repertoire holds a vast richness of inspiration for the bassoonist. For us, the art of bassoon playing is the expression of our elemental desire to sing. I hope this presentation has been helpful to you in fulfilling that desire.